as you see, I'm planning on making a pumpkin pie. And I have my sugar pumpkin here that I grew myself that I'm very proud of. And I found this old book, this old cookbook. And it is Better Homes and Gardens Holiday Cookbook for Special Occasions. And it happens to have a pumpkin pie recipe in it. Let's see, I forgot where it was. Nope, that's not on that page. Well, let's look at pie. Here we go. Page 55. Anyway, it's a pretty neat book. Oh, and let's look at the date on this book. I'm kind of curious about the date. Let's see, when was the copyright? 1968. So out of my 1968 book, we will find the pie. There we go. There's the page. And here's the recipe for the pumpkin pie. You can just see it right there. And it's going to be this instructions. So now you see how I'm going to make my pie. And I was also looking at this Libby's Famous Pumpkin Pie. I'm going to compare these two recipes and see what I think about it. Well, I'm looking at the Libby's recipe right here. And it's really close to being the same. So I think what I'm going to do is use like the 12-ounce can of milk. I'm going to use the 3 eggs, and instead of using just milk, I'm going to use just a can of evaporated milk. Now I have a 9-inch deep dish pie pan, and I'm in the process of rolling out the crust. So, okay, another thing I'm doing is as I'm rolling it out, I'm using this little wooden dowel. I know I need to use a rolling pin, but this little wooden dowel seems to really help me get the crust thin. I'm kind of going to use my pie plate to measure. And looks like I've got a little ways to go, like on this side right here. So, back to rolling. Okay, now the pie crust is ready. And I made some little leaf shapes on there. For the little leaves. And it's thin, a thin crust, which I prefer because I hate pie crust on pumpkin pie that's really thick. So, anyway, this is ready to put in the refrigerator until we're ready to fill the pie. Okay, now I'm ready to mix the pie, and I've got my crust ready, and I'm just going to, basically, I did use my mixer to kind of blend the filling up a little bit to, you know, make it creamy and smooth it out. But basically, you're just going to blend all the ingredients in here, the eggs, the sugar, your spices, and just start mixing them in there. Break up the eggs. And now that I've got the eggs broke up a little bit, I'm going to add the milk. So, let me just put in our milk, the whole can, 12 ounces. I kind of changed the recipe a little bit, but I do that a lot when I cook. So I guess I just like doing things my way. Okay, now my pie is ready to go in the oven. Preheated at 400 I have a feeling since this is a deep dish, and I did sneak a little bit more pumpkin in there, it's going to take probably more than an hour. But probably 50 minutes or an hour, or until a knife inserted halfway between the center and the outside edge comes out clean. So it's time to put this in the oven. Now, what pumpkin pie is complete without some whipped cream? So what you need is a cup of heavy whipping cream, a tablespoon of sugar, half teaspoon of vanilla extract, and you are just going to beat it. Okay, the whipped cream is done. We can't overbeat it, it'll get buttery. And I switched to the wire whisk and it worked great, so.
Much better.
Yes.
I got a big old fart right here.
Okay, we're getting a taste test. What does Dad think about it?
That's plum delicious, dear.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Boy, that's plum delicious, honey.
What do you do? Actually, hey, Erin, what do you think about the pumpkin?
I think pumpkins would be good.
They taste just like butter. Popcorn.
I like them. They have a lot of fiber on them.
Yeah, they are fibers.
Quite tasty indeed.
Just pretend like I'm not doing a video. Oh, yeah. What do you think?
Please, Mom, can I have some more?
Is it good, though?
Quite the delicious pie you've made here, my dear.
It must be really good because he doesn't normally talk this way.
Indubitably so.
Indubitably.
Okay.